Okay, so today we're looking at the Casio Edifice EQB501D, which features an alarm, an auto calendar, Bluetooth functions, phone finder, average speed display, two time zones, and a stopwatch function, all through your mobile phone. If we look closer at the dial here, we can see the airplane mode at the bottom right, along with the date display and the days of the week. And this dial also acts as the speed display for the average speed. And on the left we can see the world timer function, where you can select another city to display as well as the main time for your home city. And in the centre at the top we can see the 24 hour dial next to the Bluetooth function button. Before attempting to connect the watch to the phone, it's important to make sure that the watch is not in airplane mode, which will restrict any Bluetooth connectivity. To do this, you hold down the top left button until you hear the long beep. Just like that. So now it's in airplane mode, it will not be able to connect to Bluetooth at all, so we'll have to take that out again, so hold down the top left button for around 5 seconds. And there's the beep again, and as you can see the bottom right dial, the hand has moved away from the airplane symbol, so we're now ready to connect. As you can see, I've got the Edifice app open on my phone now and I'm ready to connect to the Bluetooth. So I'm going to firstly hold down the bottom left button for about 1.5 seconds. And you hear the small beep and the phone should react. Okay, so it's connecting now and it should be successful in 1 second. And there we go. So now the watch and phone are paired correctly and we can go in to adjust all the settings on the watch. Okay, so taking a look at the app here, we can see on the main screen we have at the bottom left corner the battery display, where we can see the level that it's currently at. Obviously it's a solar watch, so it will need recharging with the lights. And also on here we can have the world time function, where the different cities can be changed, along with the stopwatch and alarm functions. We also at the top right have the guide menu, so it will tell you in depth which each button and dial does for you in each different mode. So alarm, stopwatch, and world time. Okay, so now that the watch and phone are paired successfully, we can take a look at more functions on the app. Firstly, we have the world time function here, which is currently set at New York, and that's for the dual time on the watch. So say if we wanted to change that to Paris, we can select that and send the settings to the phone. And then on the watch, we can see that it's changing the left-hand dial for Paris's time zone. Okay, so now if we go into this menu at the top here, we can see watch settings and more specifically adjusting home positions, which is very important. As you can see, our hour hand is not correct. So it looks like we're 10 minutes off there, so we need to offset that by 10 minutes to match up the dial of the watch. And as soon as we've got that, we can send the setting to the watch and that should change as soon as we send the setting. As you can see, it is now correct. As I said before, this watch actually features a phone finder function, so if you ever were to lose your phone, you'd be able to use the watch to send a notification to the phone alerting you to where it is. So you can do that by going into the settings and the phone finder settings here, and you can adjust the volume and a couple of different sounds that you can choose from. Or you can alternatively choose your own music from the Apple Music collection.